الله أكبر، الحمد لله رب.
Get out, you!
Oh Allah, fix things between me and my dad.
Hello guys, you're welcome back. My name is Bukumi Bikekran. So, this Chinese dad actually loses it after his son became a Muslim. So let's check it out.
Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.
Subhana Rabbi Azim. Subhana Rabbi Azim. Subhana Rabbi Azim.
What the hell? Get out, you! Go! You know my son! Go! Don't come back! No Muslim? Come back! Muslim? Go! Go!
Peter, saw this. Peter, is this a sleeping bag? Have you been sleeping out here? What's wrong?
Kicked out.
What?
My dad kicked me out.
So sorry. I don't know what to say. Why'd he kick you out?
Because I became Muslim. Hmm.
Boys, what happened?
What happened? You alright?
Peter got kicked out.
No way. Hmm. Are you alright?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Peter, you'll be alright, yeah? Because this is just a test. Like, I was tested with money. I guess you're tested with faith, right? So, we'll come strong with it. We'll find a way. Maybe you can live with me.
I don't want to inconvenience you. It's fine, man.
What do you mean by inconvenience, bro? You helped me out when I was in need, right? So this is my time to help you. Yeah? What do you say?
Come on.
Yeah? Let's pack him up, boys. Come on.
Hey, let's go.
Hey, the bedroom,
you grab that ball, man. Come on.
So yeah, welcome to my humble abode. It's not the biggest, but alhamdulillah.
It'll do.
Make yourself at home, bro. I'll get your bags.
Quran.
Hey, Tanvi.
What's up?
Can't thank you enough, bro. I really appreciate it.
For the 100th time, brother. It's all good. This guy.
Yo. I got this stuff. 5 minutes till Adhan. Can't wait for it, bro. Yo, biryani, your favorite.
You alright?
Yeah, man. It's just my dad.
Your dad, huh?
I haven't heard from him.
Yeah, I know what it feels like. It's been ages since I've seen my family. It's my first Ramadan here and it's just not the same. Like, back in Pakistan, bro, like, this table will be full of people. Oh, and the food, bro. We got all types of biryani, all types of rice, naans, kebabs. Oh, bro. And korma. Lamb korma and chicken tandoori, bro. Tandoori chicken is the best.
Oh. Sounds amazing, bro.
It is, yeah. Mm-hmm. You know what? Why don't you make dua? Like, we've been fasting the whole day and it's almost iftar time. This is the best time to ask Allah for anything you want.
How do I do that?
Alright, so you raise your hands and you ask Allah for whatever you want from the bottom of your heart and be sincere.
Oh Allah, fix things between me and my dad. Oh Allah, open my dad's heart to Islam. Oh Allah, guide my dad. What do I do now?
Say Ameen.
Ameen.
Yeah, that's it. Now we just put faith in Allah. You know what? Call him right now. You've just made dua, you put your trust in Allah. Now you should do something. Call your dad.
I don't know, man.
Come on. It's been 2 months. Take that leap. I think it's time.
Okay. So, you hung up on me.
At least you tried, yeah?
Thank you. No. That was so good.
Yeah?
Thanks, bro.
All good. You know what? I'll wash up and then we'll go pray. Yep.
Easy. I'm doing that.
Allahu Akbar.
That was really good. No.
Allahu Akbar.
No.
Allahu
Akbar. Hi, you've reached Peter. I can't take your call right now. Please leave a message and I'll get back to you when I can.
Peter? Come home. I love you. Peter. Okay.
Come home. I love you.
I'm sorry, Peter. I'm sorry.
Wow, that was a very powerful message, beautiful one. I love the fact that when the father sent him out of the house, he didn't insult him, he didn't fight with the father, he took it as fate. He just had hope that this would be better for him. And just imagine how his friend accommodated him, you know, advised him. You know, the kind of company you keep to matters in your life. That was a very good friend indeed. He also let him understand that, don't worry, your father will come. He will understand things. Just try and call him. And the father discovered the Quran and he knew that what he did was wrong. So, I know it might be tough, but may I believe that whatever your child is willing to do, just support the child. It doesn't have to be religion. Aspect alone, it can be academically, it can be, you know, job wise, anything your child is willing to do and is something that you as a father or you as a parent, you want him to be this, but this is what he wants to be or she wants to be, let her know, go for what she wants. It's about the person's life. He or she knows the best thing for his or herself. And this was a very short drama and interesting one, you know. Oh wow, this was really powerful. Even with the way the friend was like, oh, let's go and pray, it's time to pray. He was even encouraging him that, don't worry, things will be better between you. Just pray to Allah. What do you want? Said the guy said he wants things to come back to normal between him and his father. And it eventually happened. There's nothing God cannot do. When you pray unto him, everything is settled. Even when your parents disagree to so many things in your life, I'm not talking about religion alone, but if your parents disagree to so many things in your life, let them know that this is what you want and this is why you've chosen what you want. And with time, they will tend to understand and follow your dream. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Don't forget to smash that subscribe button for more. Like, share, and comment. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.